Welcome to Chikela Christian School. I would like first to present to you the mission of our school. The goal of Chikela Christian School is to provide, in unison with the parents, a quality, Bible-based, Christian-centered education, wherein each child may grow in grace, wisdom, knowledge, and wonder, and so be enabled to responsibly serve God, others, and creation, as His image bearers in all areas of life. We cherish a school with Christian character, quality teachers and facilities, encouraging a rich diversity of student activities, appreciated by the community, producing enlightened, exuberant and successful Christian graduates who will work to reclaim God's creation for Christ. Adopted a working style which resembles that of Jesus.
Very good.
We have adopted a working style that is based on a life that demonstrates honesty, vision, sacrifice, and love. We confirm what we teach by our lifestyles. We concur with Thomas Fuller, who said, "A good example is the best sermon."
Okay, so let's count from 20, going
backwards, until which number?
20.
20. 20.
Let's go.
20, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15.
From 1 up to 15, let's count together forward.
Good afternoon. My name is Iris Noliama, and I'm an educator at Chikewa Christian School. I'm currently the head of section at the Foundation Girls School. Our school is a very big school divided into three sections. I'm heading part of primary school, which is the Foundation Girls section, comprising of art. This is a very important part of education in a child's life. This is where we teach learners how to read and write. And we start doing this right from the part of that. Our activities are mainly aimed at building a child physically, socially, psychologically, emotionally.
Writing and handwriting. Let me break down the concepts for you. I love listening and speaking because that is when I get to listen to my teacher's loud voice as it changes from sweet to harsh, low to high, according to the story she will be reading to us. I also listen to the strange morning news from my fellow classmates. We pay more attention because we have to answer questions afterwards.
Reading and comprehension. Through this concept, I can read and answer questions as well as understand what I am reading.
We teach life skills, English, at an home language level, and at the first national level, and it matters.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Orifune, and this is and we are going to talk about number poem.
Present about synonyms. Synonyms are words with the same meaning. For example, mistake, error, start, begin, reach, wealth, ill, sick, and finish. Thank you.
Fact about 12. 12 is made up of 1/10 and 2 units.
12 is an even number. There are 12 months in a year. The word doesn't mean 12.
Now please help me to build the number 12. 5 plus 7 equals to 12.
10 plus 2 equals to 12.
11 plus 1 equals to 12.
9 plus 3 equals to 12.
6 plus 6 equals to 12.
8 plus 4 equals to 12.
Friends, do we have the number 12 in the Bible?
Yes!
Jesus had 12 disciples. Jacob had 12 sons. Moses sent 12 spies into Canaan.
Ishmael has 12 sons. John sees a woman wearing a crown with 12 stars on it.
The apostles will sit on 12 stones. Elijah tears his coat into 12 pieces.
The teachers that you are going to see are just a glimpse of what we are doing. Not necessarily everything, but just as part of what we are teaching our learners in the classroom. This includes educational activities, whereby learners prepare the activities from their favorite topics or themes. This includes activities like mathematical activities, English language activities, rhymes, and
calls. Wait a second, stop. You must stay in the house and you must not get outside. get in a car. And you must close all windows. And please don't touch any metal. Because if you do touch any metal, you will feel a slight shock. And thank you.
Good day, everyone. In length, we learn about subtraction. And we are going to do one rhyme for you about a wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Nine jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Eight jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Seven jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Six jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Five jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Four jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Three jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Two jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. One jellyfish swimming in the dish. A wiki waka, wiki waka, one fell down. Four jellyfish swimming in the dish.
We use rhymes and poems a lot in foundation-based education because they are a very fun way of teaching. Remember, we are teaching program things that you can come up with creative activities that captivate and help them to improve their concentration time. So rhymes, songs, and poems have had we usually use rhymes, you know, the same as business status because they hope our learners to have fun first before we teach them and also them to help them to be curious of what the teacher is doing in their lesson.
Noise pollution. Noise pollution is when we make a lot of noise and can cause hearing problems. These are the types of, these are examples of things that make noise pollution. Loud traffic, school bells, and concerts.
9 plus 41 equals 50. 10 plus 40 equals 50. 20 plus 20, 30 plus 20 equals 50.
And 0 plus 20 equals to 20. 1 plus 90 equals to 20. 2 plus 18 equals to 20. 3 plus 17 equals to 20.
The repetition that they make in rhymes and songs help them to improve their memory and their concentration. It also helps us to integrate all the subjects together because we have specific rhymes for mathematics. We also have specific rhymes for life skills and for English language. They help to teach our learners sounds, and when our learners learn sounds, they can build words and ultimately learn how to read, write, and to write, to build words, and also to write sentences. Sentences which also finally build up paragraphs. So we encourage children to build our vocabulary through the poems that we give them to recite, read and write. They also help them to be creative and also develop their interpretation skills.
The sun is hot, put on your hat, take your costume, we are going for a splash, keep to the shade.
full stop. We put it at an end of a sentence. Comma. It means you have to take a breath. Semicolon. Used to join two related sentences.
Amongst the activities, we also have songs and Bible verses. This is because we are a Christian school and our education is rooted in the Bible. We offer Bible verses. It is part of our time development classes. This constitutes activities like reading the Bible, reading Bible stories, bringing in Bible teachers, asking learners to relevant teacher for the story that we have taught them. We also teach them songs, Christian songs. We also pray in our classroom. So some of the activities are coming from our Bible lessons and our songs and activities. Since I mentioned that we are a Christian institution, we also celebrate Christian festivals. And currently, the whole country is in the Christmas mood. That is why we are seeing our learners singing Christmas carols. But this is not the only Christian festival that we celebrate as an institution. We have, for example, the Ascension Day, we commemorate it. We also have activities that are specifically meant for that. All in all, I can say my speech sums up the really need to what you want. Thank you.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let every sin be king. Let every heart prepare in room. And heaven it shall see. And heaven it shall see.
My name is Maradzi Okhetro, and I am the high school head boy of Chikeva Christian School. Chikeva Christian School is a school that is dedicated to its Christian values. From a young age, children are taught to value their Bibles, to value the values that they are taught here at school, through instigations such as daily devotions, such as including our Bible work into our curriculum. Every day we are encouraged to do better in our walk with Christ. Chikeva Christian School is a conducive environment for both athletic and academic development. Through programs such as sport competitions, our healthy competitive nature drives us as students to do better in all aspects of our learning capabilities. Chikeva Christian School creates a vibrant and inclusive atmosphere through development programs such as our cultural evening and our Abba Day programs, which show worldly awareness of current affairs. The school is very involved in student matters. From educators to higher positions of authority, every aspect of the school is dedicated to the development of each and every one of its students. In conclusion, Chikeva is dedicated to creating a future generation that is well-rounded in every aspect they could possibly be.
Today, Abba Day is celebrated across the world. In 1983, Abba Day was first celebrated in South Africa. Today, we have a whole week dedicated to trees, National Abba Week. So this is the day where we think back and appreciate how trees are important to us. Today is the beginning of a new season, spring. So go out there and throw a shade. Let us plant trees.
Ascension is nicely recorded in the book of Acts chapter 1. In my first book, I told you, Theophilus, about everything Jesus began to do and teach until the day he was taken up to heaven after giving his chosen apostles further instructions through the Holy Spirit. During the 40 days after he suffered and died, he appeared to the apostles from time to time, and he proved to them in many ways that he was actually alive, and he talked to them about the kingdom of God.
I confide in you, 'cause you're the only answer that matters. Even in the darkness, you will be my light. Shaken, I will not be moved. Even in the chaos, I know that you're good. Lord, bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord, turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you.
make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
We continue to pray in the name of Jesus. Omnipotent Father, we are gathered here not in any other name, but in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for Chikeva Management Board. And we thank you for the School Management Board. Thank you for their lives. Thank you for their families. Thank you for protecting them this year. Many a times, Father, they spend many hours here at school discussing issues to build this institution. Discussing issues, Father, policies that will discipline the learners, the leaders of tomorrow. Discussing issues, how to empower and to continue to encourage their teachers. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for being with them. We give you all the glory and adoration. We thank you. In the same spirit, Father, we pray and say, Abba, Father, like Jesus did. We pray that, Father, we usher them into 2024. May they continue to be humble and seek your face when they meet to discuss issues concerning the Chikeva family. In the name of Jesus, give them your wisdom, grant them your compassion, make them strategists like Nehemiah. Give them the spirit of compassion like our Lord Jesus Christ. May they continue to have gathering like this, where they acknowledge you, just like the leper. When Jesus healed the 10 lepers, only one that returned and said, Master, I am healed and therefore thank you. We continue to pray that the leadership of the school will continue to uphold the Christian principles in the name of Jesus and instill them in the learners. For it is not easy for them to minister and administer to a multitude of parents and learners and educators coming from different backgrounds, different religions, but they have the task to minister to them, to create an environment of peace, love, and a friendly atmosphere for teachers to work, for learners to learn. Fathers, we continue to usher them. We stand on the word, that scripture in Psalm 32, verse 8, where the Lord encourages us. I will watch over you. I will instruct you and show you the path which you should take. In the same spirit, we stand here together and we pray with the leadership of Chikeva Christian School. We say the Lord will be with you. He will watch over you. He will guide over you as you administer your word, for it is not easy. We ask all this, not in any other name, but in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Everything comes to an end. Above all, we thank God. It is through His grace that we are here, that we have our loving parents, our wise teachers, this school, and our very lives. It is through His mercy that we are able to pass through the glory and the joy of our journey last month. And to you all, we thank you. We thank you again, and we thank you once more. What a wonderful story we have written with you all. And although it's time for goodbyes, in the words of Winnie the Pooh, how lucky you are to have something that makes saying goodbye so hard. On behalf of the class of 2023, it has been a pleasure. So for the very last time, this class of 2023 is signing out.
As a student of Chikewa, I believe that the diversity of culture and the variety of learning programs creates a dynamic learning experience for all.